Hello friend, welcome you all to my channel Learn Innovatively with me. My name is Shashi Bhushan Chauhan and today I am going to show you that how you can perform one-way ANOVA test in Graphpad Prism software. And one-way ANOVA is a technique that can be used to compare whether two sample mean are significantly different or not. So you can see on my laptop screen. Here I am showing a data level of interferon gamma in control, treatment A and treatment B group, and you can see the data in all three groups. So how you can do one-way ANOVA test using Graphpad Prism software? For this, open your Graphpad Prism software. In the Graphpad Prism software, in the column, if you click here on the enter or import data in a new table and click on create, this will open the panel in which you can put your data in the respective group. But if you click here on the start with a sample data to follow a tutorial, and here it is extended, but maybe in your case it is minimized. So to show the option, click here on the plus button, you can see the option. So in one-way ANOVA there is two option: ordinary one-way ANOVA and repeated measure one-way ANOVA. So today I am going to discuss about only ordinary one-way ANOVA, and I will discuss the repeated measure one-way ANOVA later in my tutorial. So select this and click on here create. Here you can see the data already present for tutorial purpose in the Graphpad Prism software. You can select and delete this data, and you can copy your data from the Excel sheet and paste in the Graphpad Prism software. And to analyze the data, you can click here on the analyze button and also in the result section, new analysis. But before this, you can see the graph of this data if you click here, and here is the option to select the graph type. Here I am selecting the mean, median and error in which column bar graph. You can see the graph of the entered data, and now click here on the analyze button, and you can see in the column option one-way ANOVA. Click here, and at the right side you can see the your sample group. You can select or deselect group accordingly and click here on the OK. And now a new window is open to select the parameter, and first you can see the experimental design, in which you can see there is two experimental design. First, no matching or pairing. So you can see there is no matching in your group data, and if you select the each row represent matched or repeated measure data, you can see each row representing the paired sample. But in my case, there is no matching or pairing paired data, so I'm selecting the no matching or pairing, and assume the Gaussian distribution of residuals. So for this, you can perform a normality test. So I'm going to show you how you can perform the normality test. For this, select your data and click here on analyze, and in the column analysis, select the normality and log normality test here. Click here and OK. And here is the option to select the test to analyze the normality. So by default it is selected from all the tests, so I'm not going to change this. Click here on the OK, and here you can see first two tests showing that there is too small sample, that's why they are unable to perform the test. And in the last two tests, here you can see the past normality test, yes, for all three groups. So you can see our data is normally distributed, and I am assuming Gaussian distribution of residual, so I am selecting yes. And also for the equal standard deviation, here I am also selecting yes. Now if you click repeated measures, as I have not selected for the repeated measure, so here it is not showing anything. So next, click on the multiple comparison. This is for the post hoc test analysis, so by default it is none. But if you click here, compare the mean of each column with the mean of every other column. If you click here, it also perform the test for the mean of one group with the mean of every other groups if you select this. But if you select the next one, compare the mean of each column with the mean of control, in this case it performed the test from the mean of control group to other groups. And the next one, compare the mean of pre-selected pair of column. So you can select the group in which you want to perform the post hoc test. But I am going to select the compare the mean of each column with the mean of every other column. And the next option here is the multiple comparison test. If you select this, you can see there is a Tukey, Bonferrini, Sydak, Holmes-Sydak, and Newman-Quills test for multiple comparison tests. But here you can see the graph pattern recommending the Tukey test. So I'm selecting the Tukey test for the multiple comparison test. But maybe in your case, you can change accordingly. And I am leaving with the default value here. And in the additional result, if you click here on the descriptive statistics for each data set, the result will be in the descriptive form also. Next, residuals. So I am leaving these option and click here on the OK. Here you can see an average result and multiple comparison, and here also the descriptive statistics. So you can see in the average result there is a significant difference, and if you click here on the multiple comparison, you can see it analyzes the data control versus treatment A, control versus treatment B, and also treatment A versus treatment B. And here you can see the result, control versus treatment A have the significant difference, and treatment A versus treatment B also have the significant difference, but there is no changes between control and treatment B, you can see here. And if you click here on the descriptive statistics, you can see the descriptive analysis of that control, treatment A and treatment B group. So in this way, you can perform the one-way ANOVA test in GraphPad Prism software. And I hope this may help you in your research. And if you like the video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.